Hello, it's Dan Bull. Can anyone smell that? It's like really badly burnt rice, chewing gum or something. Anyway, in case you weren't aware, iDubbbz has just blown up the internet by releasing a 30-minute long video totally decimating fellow YouTuber and questionable human being, RiceGum. It's quite good, watch it here. Well, now RiceGum has announced he's going to be releasing a response to iDubbbz. The thing is, we already know it's going to be shit. Well, here's the thing, I've also written a diss track against iDubbbz that's not as shit as RiceGum's inevitably will be, even though I wrote mine 2 years ago and it's way past its expiry date. See, back then I decided, repeatedly, to make a series called Roasts, where I pick someone out, make a vlog about them, and at the end just roast them with raps. Hence the name, Roasts. And now, criticizing other people through the medium of rap is the biggest YouTube trend of current year. I'm a YouTuber who enjoys criticizing other people through the medium of rap, and I haven't done one. I'm a buffoon. Bloody PewDiePie directly invited me to do one against him, and I still haven't done one. What a buffoon! So now I thought would be the perfect time to kick off rap. To kick the series off properly by showing you a track I made about iDubbbz back in 2016 when he wasn't exponentially more successful than I am. I'm not bitter. Funny guy. Stole his catchphrase from a 1940s infomercial about rotoscoping.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Yes, it is.
Hey, that's pretty good.
Yes, it is. Funny guy. I'm not bitter. So, why did it take so long for me to get round to releasing this track? Well, after I wrote the song, I sort of somehow had a baby, as well as getting addicted to Dark Souls and Scotch whiskey. So, all the memes and references in the song you're gonna hear are literally older than my son. But let's just pretend they've matured like a fine wine, cheese, or mature content warning. The following song contains violence, drug references, childish shock humour, and casual homophobia. I wanted to talk to Ian on his own level, and I also thought, you know, rap doesn't really have enough of that stuff already. It's very conservative and safe, isn't it, rap?
Can't keep my dick in my pants.
Here's the song.
What we do here is go back.
Hello, Ian. How the hell have you been? It's me again, your favourite rapping European. I'm here to leave you burnt like black toast. Welcome to the first ever episode of Rap Roast. Ian, the type of content you make that gross? You just milk intolerance. Lactose. Now, for anyone who's unfamiliar with your channel watching, you do a really funny series called Ban Unboxing. So I brought a box full of props and raps I'm dropping, and after that, you can use it as your actual coffin. You already know smoking's bad for your health, so you must really crave having two fags in your mouth. Time to de-stress, stop and take a deep breath. Not because you need air, fuck, I just wanna hear you speak less. You look a reek mess, Woody Allen meets meth. Your ideal orgies are sausage meat fest. You're so scrawny and you've got such a meat chest that you still wear your age 0-3 vest. Invisible eyebrows on fleek, yes. With specs that thick, you're never gonna see chef. Of all the Ians in the world, you're the least best. You're a bad driver, you deserve to have your Jeep wrecked. You frail cracker, I could snap you like a cracker jack. And by the way, the pass wants his glasses back. I'm a bit funny looking, check the size of my head. It's still got nothing on your giant surprise, eh? I'd like to break it open, that'd be delightful. You look like a scrotum rolled over a light bulb. When you were born, your mum thought she'd either done a turn or given birth to a puppet out of Thunderbirds. Say something, I'll take your fake diamond play button and give you a face fucking so you can taste sucking. You lame shutting, get out and get some sunlight. Training for a fight's quite effective if it's done right. But you don't want to get into the ring with Jinx. You do want to get into Jinx's ring, methinks. Ugh, sitting in your room, topping up your cummy sock, and sucking out every fluffy, crusty, yummy drop like a hungry Winnie the Pooh tongue in a honey pot. And when you catch a cold, you bukkake runny snot, bouncing up and down on your thumb like a bunny hop, shouting, "Mummy, watch, you're gonna miss the money shot." Sonny, stop before your breech get a heavy leak. The human rectum shouldn't stretch more than 10 inch deep. Remember when we went to Venice Beach? You kept walking round talking with insensitive offensive speech, till you annoyed a fella with Floyd Mayweather's physique, and he did to you what Drake did to Meek. Ooh, drama alert, someone contact Keemstar. You're not a real cop, Ian, where's your police car? Rearrange the letters in content cop and see that it's an anagram of concept, not Kickstarter crap, crapscater trip, prick attacks, crack raper tits. Okay, even when I say that, I'm cleverer than iDubbbz. More popular too, here, have some of my subs. You're just like me, we're both acting like thugs, but are prone to panic attacks in nightclubs. Yo, the only time that you would fire slugs was if your zoo was overstaffed and you don't like bugs. Museums are the only time of you seeing nice jugs, and your dealer needs to see prescriptions when you buy drugs. And now it's crunch time for the final punchline. I can't come up with one, so just like and subscribe. Cringe. I'm just playing. iDubbbz, you know I love you.
Same.
Hey, RiceGum. Isn't it a bit embarrassing when a pasty, chubby British guy releases an old, discarded demo track that's still funnier than your main diss track? I'm not even normally this arrogant, but come on, raise the bar a little bit. Now then, audience, who do you think should be my next roast vegetable? It could be a friend, an enemy, or just someone you think needs a good talking to and a smacked botty. 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 Sorry. Let me know the reasons why, and I might actually do it this time before those reasons become totally irrelevant. I've had 2 years practice since I made that track, which I didn't even publish at the time because it was meh. But the next roast. The next episode is going to be lit. It's going to be more eloquent, more brutal, and more truthful. I mean, come on, no one's funnier than iDubbbz. Why did I say that? And no one is immune from being roasted. Oh, and FYI, Ian thinks this is how you spell diss track. Oh yeah, and if you want to hear that song again without all the talking bollocks in front of it, you could find it on Spotify. I've got an epic playlist full of pretty much all my tracks, and I've even just started a rap roast playlist just for you. Links are in the description. Click them. Bye.
Damn ball.
Don't go back.